Tesla recently closed the deal to buy Maxwell Technologies, which is a big, big deal. It's another one of the laundry list of items that investors and analysts seem to not fully appreciate how much this may push Tesla even further ahead of the competition. But before I jump into this, take a moment and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on future videos just like this one. I'm Matt Ferrell, welcome to Undecided. I covered Maxwell Technologies in my batteries and supercapacitors video, but now that Tesla has officially closed the deal, I thought it was worth a deeper dive. In case you don't know who the company is, Maxwell Technologies is an American energy storage company that was founded in 1965. They're primarily known for their commercial products and ultracapacitors. Their experience and production techniques they used in manufacturing ultracapacitors led them to something that they call the dry battery electrode technology for battery production. That innovation is the primary reason that Tesla purchased the company, and there are several reasons why that's such a big deal. When asked about the Maxwell Technologies integration at the Tesla Autonomy Day event, Elon responded,
"I mean, you're really asking some secret source questions here. Yeah, I think we'll have a. I think we'll probably have an investor day, like we had Autonomy Day, maybe later this year or early next, just to go over the." A cell and battery technology and future strategy, and I think that'll be very informative. But we do recognize the criticality of this.
So clearly, there are some big things coming out of this deal. Here's my take on all the information we have so far. First, dry battery electrodes is an innovation in the manufacturing process of the anode and the cathode that doesn't require any liquid solvent in the process. This shouldn't be confused with solid-state batteries, though. Usually in the manufacturing of lithium batteries, the materials are sprayed on with a toxic solvent that then has to be dried and baked off. The solvents in the process create off-gassing and pollution. So Maxwell's dry electrode process actually improves the ecological side of battery production. With the main goal of Tesla being to accelerate the world's transition to sustainable energy, making the production process cleaner and more sustainable is also part of that goal. Second, energy density. Batteries built using the DBE method show greater than 300 watt-hours per kilogram with a path to over 500. By comparison, Tesla's current battery technology, which is considered one of the highest densities available today, is believed to be around 250. That means this technique could add about 20% to Tesla's current battery density with room to double it. This will lead to vehicles with significantly more range. You'd be pushing Tesla Model 3s to something closer to 400 miles per charge, and it would go up from there. On the other hand, you could also keep the range the same and reduce the number of cells needed to achieve that goal, which would also reduce the weight of the car and also the production cost. Third is battery life. The batteries are also showing improved durability with battery life almost doubling. Elon recently stated,
"The current battery pack is about maybe 300 to 500,000 miles. The new battery pack that's probably going to production next year is designed explicitly for 1 million miles of operation. The entire vehicle, battery pack inclusive, is designed to operate for 1 million miles with minimal maintenance.
That's a pretty bold statement to make and a very Elon thing to say, but it's clearly tied to the DBE method that they just acquired. But I'm not convinced it's solely on the DBE production technique. One of the things that Maxwell Technologies touted as a huge benefit of their technique was that it can be applied to different cell chemistries. Tesla has been spending a great deal of time and effort on researching new chemistries themselves to reduce and remove cobalt from the mix. The research group is led by Jeff Don in Halifax, and they patented a new battery cell chemistry that is supposed to result in faster charging, discharging, battery longevity, and even lower cost. Jeff Don has been working on lithium-ion battery chemistry for decades. His group used to have a 20-year research agreement with 3M, but in 2016, he associated with Tesla, and they applied for this new battery chemistry patent in 2017. So why do I think that's important to call out? Well, it's kind of like Reese's peanut butter cups.
Hey, you got your chocolate in my peanut butter!
What?
Tesla's new chemistry with improved performance is the peanut butter, and Maxwell Technologies' DBE production method, which also offers improved performance and longevity, is the chocolate. Or maybe that's the other way around. But regardless, with these two things combined, you end up with something that could launch Tesla even further ahead of the competition. Or as Elon said,
"New battery pack that's probably going to production next year is designed explicitly for 1 million miles of operation.
And finally, another huge, massive, gigantic reason that Tesla purchased Maxwell: cost reduction and production capacity. Well, to be more accurate, it's smaller scale. As I mentioned earlier, the typical battery production process involves using wet toxic chemicals to create the cathode, which then has to be dried and baked off. That involves a lot of floor space and ovens for that step of the process. With the DBE method, you skip that step completely, which results in a 16 times production capacity increase. You're able to produce a lot more batteries in the same amount of factory space. You also save cost by eliminating that step as well for about a 10 to 20% cost reduction. Tesla reminds me of Apple in a lot of ways. Both are companies that believe in full vertical integration. When you control all aspects of product design and production, you can create truly optimized user experiences and achieve incredible economies of scale. Apple has been designing its own silicon for the iPhones, iPads, and Apple Watches for years now. They can tailor their silicon to support software, features, and hardware capabilities, which means devices that have incredible battery life and still feel snappy. Tesla has been doing the same thing with everything from building their own car seats to the autonomous driving computer that they just built for themselves. And with batteries being the most important part of an electric vehicle, it makes a lot of sense for Tesla to pull that in-house too. The fact that the investors and analysts either discount or completely ignore this as one of Tesla's strengths is completely baffling to me. Tesla already has a tremendous lead over the competition when it comes to their motors, the software, electronics, and batteries. With all the moves that Tesla is making, it looks like they're extending that lead and continuing to out-innovate the competition. If anything, I'd expect that to be exactly what investors would want to see. I'd love to hear what you think. Jump into the comments and let me know if I missed an angle on how the Maxwell deal may impact Tesla. Are you excited to see how this improves Tesla's cars and energy storage? And if you liked this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends because it really does help the channel. And if you'd like some other ways to help the channel, there's some ways that you can do so. Want some cool t-shirts like the one I'm wearing? Check out my SFSF shop for some cool Tesla, SpaceX, science, and Undecided t-shirts. Every purchase helps to support the channel. And as always, an extra big thank you to all of my Patreon supporters. Your ongoing support really does help the channel. And if anyone else is interested in early access to videos, behind the scenes posts and polls, check out my Patreon page for additional details. And if you haven't already, consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell to get alerts when I post new videos. And as always, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.